To Belfast's lonely graveyard I strayed one autumn night. Around a grave a crowd I saw in the evening's fading light, and from the men and women folk who knelt around that mound came the patters and the aves in a soft-toned Gaelic sound. Within this grave a young man speaks, lie two of Ireland's sons, who gave their lives in freedom's cause and faced the tyrant's guns. On Cavan's mountain, Lappandoff fought one with bravery, until the English soldiers killed brave Sean McCartney. In Mountjoy jail the other one, on Mary's festive morn, the bright red cloak of martyrdom for Ireland did adorn. And as the church bells chimed their pain to Mary Immaculate, a Free State firing party sent Joe McKelvey through death's gate. And father there across the path lies one who knew not Ken, a soldier who in Ireland's cause his life he gladly spent. Through battle fire and prison cell and comrades' treachery, brave Paddy Nash withstood it all until death claimed victory. And all around are monuments that bear a martyr's name, true patriots who had served and died to kindle freedom's flame. Ned Trodden, Gaynor and O'Carroll, with Marcus Stocker brave, remember them, they died for us and found a martyr's grave. And oh my friends, look farther there, a grave just freshly made, a boy we all loved in our hearts, therein that grave is laid. When just a boy of 16 years, a felon's cap he wore, God rest you, Frankie Doherty, Ireland's cross you proudly bore. The ceremony's over, the crowd is gone and I'm alone, with thoughts that take my memory back to McCracken and Wolfe Tone. And in every generation still, they come that noble band to sacrifice their brave young lives in the cause of Ireland.